So we will continue with the concurrency control protocols. Next, we will be studying this validation based protocol. So this is called the validation or certification based protocol. So what happens in this is that the transaction or the, all the transactions in a schedule has three distinct phases. The first phase is called the read and execution phase. So what happens in this phase is that all the transactions in the schedule read the variables from the database and execute on them, but write on the temporary values in those databases. So it only writes to temporary variables, not to the actual database values. So only the temporary values of this are modified. That is part of this transaction, this is part of the schedule. So nothing is being changed in the actual database. So this is just a temporary variable. This is important. In the second phase, the second phase is called the validation phase, which is why this protocol is called a validation based protocol. What happens in this validation phase is that now it is actually being checked whether these writes that were going through in the first phase, in the execution phase and read phase, can be done without violating the serializability. So this validation test is done. There is something called a validation test. So the validation test essentially checks whether variables can be written, whether it can be written without violating the serializability, whether transaction can complete without violating the serializability. So whether all those writes that are thing are correct in the sense of, they are correct in the sense of serializability. So without violating the serializability. So that is what the test is being done in this second phase, which is the validation phase. Okay. And in the third phase is simply called the write phase. Now there are two things that can happen in the second phase. So the transaction checks whether it can complete without violating this serializability. So if it can complete without violating the serializability, then in this third phase, these writes are actually updated to the database. So if it is yes, then writes are actually updated to the database. Writes updated in the database. So that's essentially, that means that all the writes that were in the temporary variables are now actually propagated to the database. On the other hand, this violating serializability may also answer no, which means that if the transaction proceeds, then it will violate the serializability. So that means it should not proceed. So essentially, this is akin to a rollback. So the transaction must roll back. Now, what does this rollback means is that, so the transaction must not write anything to the database. Now, actually notice that the transaction has not written anything to the database anyway. It has written only to the temporary variables. So the rollback actually meaning it does nothing. It just simply does not update the writes in the database. So it does nothing. So there is no problem that way in the rollback phase, but that's the way to understand is that. So the critical thing about this is that it first executes assuming that everything will be correct, and then it validates whether that assumption that everything will be correct was valid or not. If it is valid, so the validation phase says yes, then that means that everything was actually correct, then it just simply goes and writes to the database. That's the writes are updated in the database. Otherwise, if everything is not valid, it cannot write anything to the database, but it has actually not written anything to the database anyway. It has written only to the temporary variables, so nothing needs to be done. Now, this is also sometimes called a optimistic concurrency control protocol. This is sometimes also known as an optimistic concurrency control protocol. Why it is called optimistic? Because the transaction actually does all the operations with the hope that the validation phase will pass successfully, with the hope that nothing is wrong, with the hope that everything is well. So that is why it is called an optimistic. So for the transaction to actually do these things, there are generally three timestamps are maintained. So three timestamps are maintained to do the actual validation step. So the three timestamps for each transaction is the start timestamp for the transaction. This is the start timestamp. Then second is the validation timestamp. This is the start of the validation phase. Now, this is the start of the transaction. This is the start of the validation phase of the transaction. So, that is the validation timestamp, start of validation phase. And finally, there is a finish timestamp, which essentially says that the end of the write phase. So, everything has gone to the database, actually being done correctly to the database. Okay. So, this is start of T, which is, you can also say this is start of the execution phase of T. That is the same as saying it is, that is the first phase. So, that is the same thing as saying it is the start of the execution. So, these are the three timestamps that the transaction uses in this optimistic concurrency protocol or the validation based protocol. Okay. Now, timestamp of the transaction. So, there is a timestamp that is given to the transaction, which is set to the validation timestamp of this. So, the timestamp, when somebody talks about the timestamp of the transaction, that is essentially the timestamp of the validation phase of the transaction. So, which is essentially equal to the validation timestamp. Now, the transactions, if everything is correct, then this is serialized. If everything is correct, then the serialization is done using this validation, using this timestamp. So, using this timestamp T. So, that serialization is done using this timestamp T, which is the same as saying that the serialization is done using the validation timestamp. So, what does it mean essentially is that suppose there are two transactions in the schedule T1 and T2, and T1 enters the validation phase earlier than T2. And suppose that there is nothing wrong in those, so the validation steps are performed correctly, then the serialization order of this of the transactions in the schedule is T1 then T2, because T1's validation timestamp is earlier than the validation timestamp of T2. Okay, fine. So, this increases the concurrency, etc. This can be also shown to be cascadeless. This is shown to be cascadeless. The reason why this is cascadeless is that if a transaction fails, essentially it will not pass the validation phase. So, it is actually not going to write anything. So, nothing needs to be rolled back in that case. So, that is the thing about these transactions. However, it can suffer from starvation. Now, this one must understand that once these timestamps are established, the timestamps of the transactions are established using these validation things, then the timestamp based ordering protocols can be used, or something similar to the timestamp based ordering protocol can be used to serialize it. So, the starvation may happen in the sense that if a transaction cannot finish, it restarts with a new timestamp. And then it must again check, etc. And then it may again not finish because some other transaction has come through again and so on and so forth. So, it keeps on starting, it keeps on restarting and keeps on rolling back or keeps on aborting. That is why it can be starved. Although theoretically there is no deadlock because these are timestamp based protocols and there is always a strict order of transactions. Between two transactions, there is always a strict order based on the timestamp of the transaction. So, there is no deadlock. But however, as we can see, this can have starvation. Now, what exactly are the validation tests that is being done? Okay. So, let us now move on to the details of the validation tests. What, how this validation phase actually does? We have been talking about the validation phase, etc. What exactly are these validation tests? So, for a transaction TI, there are two conditions that are checked for all transactions TJ. So, we are worried about transaction TI. And for all transactions TJ, such that, so the timestamps of TJ is less than the timestamp of TI, that means all transactions that started earlier, the two things are checked. The first thing is that finish TJ, finish is less than start of TI, that is the first check. The second check is that the finish TJ is earlier than the validation of validation phase of TI, and this is very importantly, and the read set. So, I'll say in a moment what a read set is, but let me just write this down. Read set of TI is disjoint width, disjoint width, right set of tj. Okay, if either of these conditions is true, then the validation passes. So if any one is true, any of this condition is true, then validation phase says yes. So validation is yes. Otherwise, it is no. Okay, all right. So what does this mean? So let us go over these two conditions one by one. So we are worried about transaction TI. Now note, for this is for all transactions TJ. So this is for all transactions TJ. It's not for a single transaction TJ. So but for all transactions TJ that has the timestamp earlier than the timestamp of the transaction TI that we are worried about, it must happen that TJ finished before TI started. Now what happens if TJ finishes before TI started? Of course, if TJ finishes, remember that the finish TJ, that timestamp is when TJ has written everything to the database. So if the TJ is completed. Now if TI starts after TJ, then of course everything is validated, nothing is wrong, because TJ was supposed to complete earlier than TI and TJ finished before even TI started. So that is fine. That is, this one is probably easier to understand why the validation is correct. Okay, then the second condition or the odd condition is that TJ finished before the validation started. Okay, now couple of things is happening. So TJ finished before validation started, but before validation of TI started, what is the TI's phase that it is into? It's the execution of the read phase of TI. So that means TI is actually reading from the database, reading some variables from the database and writing to the temporary copies of it, but it is actually reading. Now what may happen is that, think of an item X. So TI reads X, right? Now it may happen that TJ was supposed to write X and TJ wrote X after TI did. So there is a problem, correct? So it cannot say that it has validated because it's not clear when TJ wrote. But the AND condition says that the read set of TI is disjoint with the write set of TJ. That means if TI reads X from the database, TJ does not write to X. So TJ, it's disjoint. That means they do not share anything. So that means if X is read by TI, then X is not written by TJ. That means if TI read some variable Y, that is guaranteed that TJ has not written to Y. That is why it is called disjoint. So that means that the reading of Y by TI is correct, because there is no transaction TJ earlier to it which has read, which has written to it. So that way also this is correct. So that is why even if this condition is met, then the validation is also correct, and so that is why it can return validation as yes. So these are the two conditions that must be, these are the two conditions, so either of one of them must be happening for the validation to be passing. Just to remind you once more that this has to be for all TJ. No, so that means that, so suppose you are worried about the transaction T3, and before transaction T3 there is transactions T1 and T2. Now for each of these transactions, either condition 1 or condition 2 must hold. So for T1 and T2, so it may happen that T1 condition 1 holds and for T2 condition 2 holds, so that's fine. So either of these conditions must hold for T1 and T2. Only then the validation test is supposed to pass correctly. Okay. Now what is the outcome of all of these things? If this condition happens, this is essentially just serial. I mean, this is TJ finishes and then TI starts. So that is just essentially saying these are serial. And the second condition says that the reads of TI are not affected by the writes of TJ. So there is no conflict. So that means there is no conflict. So that is why these two are correct. Okay. So that's the whole thing about validation tests. This is how the validation test is done, and that is how the validation based protocol, concurrency based protocol, goes through.